We're here to celebrate, and we're a part of the Korea Peace Network and Peace Action and Code Pink and a bunch of organizations and activists from all over the U.S. who have come here.
My name's Ann Wright. I'm a retired U.S. Army colonel. I spent 29 years in the U.S. military. I was also a U.S. diplomat for 16 years, and I resigned in 2003, 15 years ago, in opposition to a war on Iraq that has devastated the Middle East. And that's why we're here. We don't want another war. We don't want a war with North Korea. And we applaud President Trump for going to Singapore to meet with Kim Jong-un. Peace is what we want. Peace, a peace treaty with the country of North Korea is what we want. So we say peace with North Korea. Thank you.
It's time to declare an end to the Korean War and replace the armistice with a peace treaty.
I was stationed in South Korea in 1980. There had been a coup and the assassination of their leader in 79. There was still a lot of unrest. There was a massacre of about 2,000 people in the city of Gwangju in May of that year. And where I was stationed, Camp Humphreys, is in the Central Agricultural Valley and was already enormous in 1980 when I was there. It has been increased to be 3 to 4 times bigger now, taking valuable farmland. Korea is a very mountainous country, so they don't have a lot of farmland. The base is enormous. There's a 50,000 person U.S. city there now.
I'm Sister Artith Platy. I've been working as it relates to nuclear weapons for many decades. We were part of developing the treaty with ICAN at the United Nations for 4.5 weeks last year. This is the answer to the questions asked as diplomacy goes on. The Nuclear Proliferation Treaty is now 47 years old. The United States signed it. North Korea had signed it and withdrew because the nations that had nuclear weapons did not keep their commitment, which was to disarm all nuclear weapons. Now we have a new treaty. It's called the Treaty for the Prohibition of Nuclear Weapons, passed by 122 nations on 7/7/17. ICAN, a group of 468 peace groups and many more now, are at the site of the summit at this very time. They are representing millions of people in the world. These are the ones, the young people and all of us, who work so hard for the abolition of nuclear weapons. They are the ones who put their lives on the line and are now getting it ratified. We now have 10 countries that have ratified it. It's 1/5 of the ones needed. We will have many more in the near future. We believe that the real resolution to the conflicts of the world is first to get rid of all nuclear weapons. There are 15,000 now, 7,000 in Russia, 7,000 in the United States, and a few in other nations. North Korea has about 6, according to what we hear. So we want the abolition of all nuclear weapons and then diplomacy throughout the world so that we will become partners in behalf of the people of this world. 7 billion plus who need food, shelter, education, health care, basic human needs. We cannot any longer spend trillions of dollars on war and killing when the life of the people of the planet and the very planet itself is at stake. Yeah. How foolish can we be to continue this type of direction? Having bases in 150 countries, there are 83 of ours in Korea alone. We must stop this whole direction toward killing. The people of the world are friends. They are not enemies until the political leaders make them enemies.
That's right.
So we continue to work for peace and for justice, and we will have it because the young people told us they want a nuclear-free world. They want a world without all these guns and killing, and they want a war-free world, and we're going to walk with them until we die, until they get it.
Yeah. I want to pause and look at the White House over here, because we have a quite unusual occupant of the White House, and probably a lot of us are not his biggest fan, but he is taking a big risk for peace, which is something that a lot of us do, but I think we do want our good thoughts to be with Mr. President.
I ain't gonna study war no more. Ain't gonna study war no more. Ain't gonna study war no more. Study war no more.